When Iron Gwazi was initially announced on March 1st, 2019, it had the coaster community going insane. However, that amount of hype is minuscule compared to the amount of hype that this coaster has gotten recently. And it recently just peaked, with Busch Gardens Tampa officially releasing their on-ride POV of the coaster. And I thought that now, with all the hype surrounding it, would be the best time to release my full in-depth analysis of the coaster. But without further ado, let's get into the video. But first, I just want to go over one thing. Everything in this video is 100% preliminary, as nobody has ridden the roller coaster yet, and you guys should save your full opinions until we actually get to ride it. But now let's get to the coaster itself. When Busch Gardens Tampa Bay opened Gwazi in 1999, it was Florida's first ever wooden coaster, and the amount of hype that it received was incredible. BGT took a chance with a relatively new coaster manufacturer, Great Coasters International, who had only built four other roller coasters before Gwazi, all of them being considerably smaller than this beast. But that chance turned out to be one of Busch Gardens' best, and Gwazi easily became one of the park's biggest moneymakers. Well, what do you know? There was actually a reason on why Gwazi was Florida's first ever wooden coaster, and that's because the other Florida theme parks actually had a clue and realized that the insane humidity, heat, and 365-day year-round operations wouldn't bode well with a wooden structure. But because Busch Gardens only cared about money then, and, well, look at what they're doing now, they decided to do it, just take a chance and see how it plays out in a few years. And well, their dumb decision happened to bite them, because just 13 years later, the Tiger side of Gwazi was forced to close, and just 3 years after that, in 2015, the Lion side was forced to close as well. So after the 2015 season, Gwazi was officially no more. And since SeaWorld had no money due to the recent effects of Blackfish, a documentary about SeaWorld and how they mistreated their animals, that really caused a significant decline in attendance, and they had no money, so they decided to just keep it standing. What harm is that gonna cause? But once they regained some of their money, they decided to demolish it in 2018, officially killing every coaster enthusiast's dream that it would become Florida's first ever RMC hybrid. However, in 2019, they decided it would be a great idea to RMC it, but the coaster was already done for. So how would they do that? They had RMC come in and pretty much build them a whole new ground-up coaster, and they would call it Iron Gwazi. Dumb name, but an amazing coaster. Now that we're done with the history of the coaster, let's go over the coaster itself, and I'll start that by dissecting the POV. As you crest the top of Iron Gwazi's lift hill, you dive down into a 91-degree, 206-foot drop. This drop looks pretty standard for every other large RMC. Just like every other RMC, this drop is surely gonna provide some insane ejector airtime in the back rows. It also has a cool head chopper at the bottom, and this drop seems very similar to Zadra's and Steel Vengeance. After this, you rise up into an outer bank turn that looks, simply put, phenomenal. It'll be sure to provide some great ejector airtime, but honestly, I think that Steel Vengeance's outer bank still looks a little bit better. But nonetheless, this will probably be the best and most people's favorite part of the ride. After that, you twist upwards into the coaster's first of three inversions. After banking pretty highly at the top, you quickly switch directions and go into what many coaster enthusiasts are dubbing the death roll. This element looks super whippy, especially if you're in the back row, which my guess will be the best seat on this coaster, and this will probably be the coaster's best inversion. However, it has two more that arguably look better, and your second inversion actually comes up right now. This overbank turn is actually banked past 135 degrees, which actually classifies it as an inversion. RMCs aren't really known for having insane positive G-forces, but this element looks very intense, especially for RMC standards. Also, when you're exiting this inversion, you will get some awesome airtime. It kind of looks like you're exiting a wave turn and looks very whippy. After this, you enter an outer bank turn. Unlike the first one on the ride, this one seems to focus more on laterals and whip over airtime, which seems to be an awesome sensation. After this, you have an off-axis step up into a bank turn, which then sends you into your third and final inversion, a zero-G stall. These are fairly common on newer RMCs, and they provide some great hang time that everybody will enjoy. After this, you have another off-axis step-up, which then sends you into a rather dead spot of the ride that will probably still have two nice pops of airtime. After that, you have one final airtime pop as you swerve into the final brake run. So no matter what way you look at it, Iron Gwazi is going to be an absolutely fantastic addition to Busch Gardens. It will be their first coaster there that actually focuses on airtime more than anything else, and I honestly think that it is a contender for the best roller coaster in all of Florida. However, Jurassic World Velocicoaster may have something to say about that. And I do not think that this roller coaster will have all that much theming, but knowing Busch Gardens, it will be presented very nicely. That's gonna wrap up this video. Let me know what you think about Iron Gwazi in the comments down below. Be sure to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and I'll catch you guys next time on Hang Time Thrills.